came up to me on Shabbat. And he told me, Daddy, I have a question. You know that the Choshen have the names of the Shevatim. Right? Reuven, Shimon, Levi, Yehuda. And he said that every time that someone had a question, was going to the Kohen Gadol. And there was a miracle happening. The letters of the Shevatim were shining and giving the right answer. So my son looked at me and he said, Daddy, it's impossible. You don't have all the alphabet in the names of the Shevatim. Ah, Hazak, huh? There is no Het, there is no Tet, there is no Tzadik. I said, Daddy, how is it possible to give an answer if the letters are missing? Rabotai, the answer, Rashi and the Rambam, how it was exactly. Both of them accepted that besides the name of the Shvatim, the name of Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov, and Shiftei Yeshurun or Shiftei Yah were written in the original. How? Listen here. According to Rashi, every single Shevet, every single tribe, have to have six letters. So, if you have Reuven, how many letters do you have? Five. You're missing one. They were adding Aleph. Right? Aleph of whom? Abraham. Then, Shimon, also missing one. You add Bet. Levi. You're missing three now. So you're gonna write next to Levi. Resh, Hey, Mem. Yeah. Resh, Hey, Mem. Abraham. Then you pass like that. It's hard. At the end, we have Shiftei Yeshurun. That's according to Rashi. The only one that didn't have anything added was the
Binyamin, you have all the six letters, and you could. That's according to Rashi. According to the Rambam, it's not Shiftei Yeshurun, it's Shiftei Yah. And Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov were written on the first stone, and Shiftei Yah was written in the last stone. Honest. However, according to both of the opinions, by adding Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov to Shiftei Yah, you have already all the letters of the alphabet, and therefore you're good to go. Understand? No. So he says, Chachamim are saying that the last stone of the Urim Tumim was called Yashpe. That was the stone of who? Of Binyamin. Why the stone of Binyamin is called Yashpe? Because she Yashpe, meaning Binyamin represents a very powerful concept that he learned it from his mother. The concept that even though you have a mouth, even though you have what to say, you keep it quiet, you don't answer. You don't say it. Binyamin, in all the story with Yosef and the selling, we never heard Binyamin talking. Not only that, we never heard Binyamin talking at all. Binyamin was a tzaddik. Why the Torah never said, but Binyamin said no. And when the Torah is saying something about Binyamin, Binyamin cries.
Amen.
He's not even talking. He says, this is the power of Yesh Peh. You have a mouth. You can talk, you can answer back. But you control yourself and you're not doing it. You know what's happening at the end with Binyamin? He's having the Beit HaMikdash in his part. He's having the Shekhinah in this place. This is Yeshpeh. Rabotai, the concept of controlling your mouth, he learned it from Rivka, you remember, from Rachel and Mechina. Remember Rachel, she gave the simanim to Leah. She gave all the signs.
Not to be embarrassed.
Not to be embarrassed. And guess what? Guess what? She suffered because of that later. When Leah says, "Avram kahtechet ishi," Yeah, you're taking already my husband and you want also the Dudaim? Rahab was able to answer her back. What are you talking about? I gave you the Simanim thing to say thank you. I never heard thank you. Huh? Does it happen to us? We do a favor. We're nice guys. Next day, whatever this guy will say something, what's our reaction? Say thank you, Habibi. I don't owe you anything. Rahab kept her quiet. She didn't answer. You know what's amazing? That Rahab, she's going to be, she's buried v'derech Hebron. And say, Chachamim, the only merit of Am Yisrael to get the Geulah is Rahab Imenu. Why? Because you were able to control your mouth.
That's right.
How strong it is, Rabotai. And how amazing at the same time it is that if you want a Yeshua, if you want a salvation from Shamayim, there is only one thing that can protect you. Not answering back. Not talking when they were... You can do it. Even though everybody's going to accept it, you know what? You can answer back. But you control yourself. I got to tell you, there was a story about a great rabbi. I forgot the name. He lived around 200 years ago. And one time, this rabbi Hasid didn't have enough money. The only thing that he had were the pair of tefillin that he got from his father, that he was a Gadol Ador. So the wife of this guy was telling him all the time, listen, sell the tefillin, people that want to buy it for fortunes, you know. Sell it and we will leave. He didn't want it to sell. So the tefillin of my dad, how are we going to do? Fine, he didn't sell it. Years passed, and really the situation was very bad. And he finds himself before Sukkot, not having money to buy an etrog. Basic. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? He was thinking. He says, you know what? I have no choice. Tefillin, I have two pairs. But the mitzvah of etrog, if I'm not going to buy, halasna. He sold the tefillin of his father and he bought the etrog. He didn't write or not, I don't know. The story is that's how it goes. So the guy, that's what he did. And he got his etrog. Beautiful, shining etrog. He came back home. And the wife looks at the box, open it. Etrog? What's going on? Etrog? She is asking her husband, you bought an etrog? Where you got the money from? She says, no, I had to sell the tefillin. She said, what? You sell the tefillin for an etrog? I'm begging you already to sell it for parnasah in the house. That's what you're doing? She was so angry. She took the etrog and she bought the pitma. She broke it. I want to see your reaction. You do kaddish on your wife. Right? Kaddishalom. The guy was, it's a shock. But instead of getting angry, by his lips, he went out, he relaxed, and he didn't answer. He said that night, his father, who passed away, came up to his dream. And he says, you have no idea which nechad ruach to Borei Olam you gave at the moment of controlling yourself. And in that merit, from tomorrow, you will never have any more need in parnasah until the last day of your life. This rabbi lived all his life. Chaval, I have his name. I will give it to you, if you want the name. All his life, he lived from that day with a tremendous berachah in his parnasah. That's a concept of the rabbotai. We having it every day. You go to the business. You go to your house with your wife. With the children, they're telling me something and you can answer back. But for what? To do my crooked? To say that you're right? You know, in Eretz Yisrael, there is a rabbi by name Rav Shmuel, Rav Benayahu Shmuel. You know about this rabbi? Big Mekuban. He's in, Shuk Machane Yehuda, you know Machane Yehuda, right? Behind Machane Yehuda, he has his yeshiva. Very big Mekuban. I'm talking about top 10 rabbis that we have in our generation. So one time, years ago, a guy came up to the rabbi and he told him, "Rabbi, I'm very, very upset, very angry, very..." "What happened?" "Listen, I have my business, I have my own store in the Shuk Mahane Yehuda. Obviously, Mahane Yehuda Shuk, it's very expensive, the rent, but it's worth it. You know, you're getting a lot of people all the time. So I was doing amazing. I had my store and I was selling whatever I was selling. Everything was going great. Rabbi, a month ago, another guy came and he opened right next door to me, the same store, same concept. And I started to realize that this guy is taking my customers. He's having a little bit better price. His store looks much nicer. And the people just started to go to him. Rabbi, I have no parnasah today. People are not stopping by. They see the other store, much more fancy, looks nicer. They enter to that store. Rabbi, I want to, you know, make a mess in his store and I'm going to show him and I'm going to ta-ta-ta. The Rabbi said, "Oh, relax. Who is giving the parnasah?" The Gemara writes, there is no concept. Listen to this concept of the Gemara. It's a mind change. No one is able to take a penny from you. So the Gemara, because en adam nichnas, a person cannot enter inside the business of the other one, even not like the
Kimlonima.
How do you say Kimlonima in English? Huh?
A hair breath.
Meaning no one can do to you anything in the business. It's not him. It's not his idea. It's whatever Borei Olam is deciding. So the guy said, "Okay, Rabbi, what should I do?" The Rabbi said, "Listen, there's nothing to look in the Shuk Mahane Yehuda. Close up the store. You're not getting anything. Open it in another place. Bezat Hashem, you're going to have benacha." The guy left the house of Rabbi Nehoshua Shmuel, very upset. And he said, "You know what? I'm going to hear whatever the rabbi said. I'm not going to get angry at this guy. Bina Shamayim and Halas." He left the store, and he left the house. He closed up the store, he opened it in another place. Where we open it? You know, Geula, Me'ah Sha'arim, over there. He opened it over there. So he had his store. And every day, there was a lady, old lady, that lived in the same building where the store was, right? And he was looking at this lady every day coming to her house. He was saying, "How are you? Good morning, good afternoon." They were talking a little. He became very nice to this lady. Very, very nice. One day, after weeks or months, one day, this lady passed next to the store. And he tells him, "Do me a favor, whenever you have the time, today, at the end of the day, come on, stay into my apartment. I want to tell you something." He was doubting if to come, and to come at the end, decided to go. He went. He got to the apartment, and the lady started to tell him all her story. And all what happened to her life. Wasn't so interested. All what happened, and he was hearing and hearing. And at the end, the lady looked at him, and she tells him, "You know, I got a very large heritage, it's called?
Heritage.
From my uncle. My uncle used to live in the US and he made a lot of money. And I have with me $5 million. I have no children. I have no grandchildren, obviously. I would like to give it to someone that I feel close. And I think that you are the man."
Wow.
He said, "You can believe that?" So the lady passed away. The guy got the money. I went back to Rabbi Nehoshua Shmuel. And the rabbi said, "You see, never by controlling yourself in the concept of not answering back, you will never lose. Even though right now it looks like, this guy gained it, this guy had the story in Machane Yehuda and I had to close it. Shvayeh, send the Shvayeh. Just wait. Wait, you're going to see how Borei Olam managed the world, and how only by the merit of controlling yourself, you're going to see a huge amount of berachah. So Rabotai, say Chachamim, that what was the greatness of Shlomo HaMelech? Shlomo, Minashon Shalem, he was complete, right? Shlomo HaMelech, he had all his force from his father, David HaMelech. What happened with David HaMelech? Say Chachamim, David HaMelech became the fourth leg of the Merkava. How do you say Merkava in English? Merkava is the
chariot
of Borei Olam. When was the moment that he became the fourth leg of the chariot of Borei Olam? Which moment? When he was escaping and there was this guy that cursed him, Kelalani Mbretzet, said the Pasuk. What's Kelalani Mbretzet? The Gemara writes seven curses, seven terrible things that said in front of everyone about David HaMelech.
No, if.
And David HaMelech, yeah, I'm not going to say, oh, then David HaMelech said, you know what? I'm not answering. Hashem Amar Lo Kalim. Borei Olam told him to curse me. It's not him. Oh, well, what do you mean it's not him? He said it. Yeah, what? Do you think that if Borei Olam will accept it, he will say it? Borei Olam Amar Lo Kalim. Therefore, he controlled himself. At that moment, said the Gemara. At that instant, HaKadosh Baruch Hu took out the name of Adam HaRishon and he put the name of David HaMelech. So Rabotai, let's try to take this concept. We'll go out to our houses. We'll go out to do our business. Don't think that it's the fault of that guy. Show yourself and you're going to see a huge amount of berachah. Baruch Adonai Olam. Amen.